It's the Funky Friday Anatomy Quiz, and it's five fast five Funky Friday questions. Remember, you can stop this video at any time if you need a little bit of time to think, as some of the questions today are quite tricky. So if you're ready, grab a pen and let's get to it. Question one, what is the celiac trunk? Also, just to clarify, it is spelt with an O in England, but no O in the US. So what is the celiac trunk? Where is it found? What does it arise from? And what are its three terminal branches? Question two, where in the body is the sural nerve? How is it formed? Where does it go? And what does it do? Question three, where is Guillain's canal? What are its boundaries? What are its contents? And for bonus points, who is it named after? Question four, where are the tonsils? How many tonsils are there? And what are they each called? And finally, the tonsils are collectively referred to as somebody's ring. Who are they named after? Question five, where is the coracoid process found? Which structures attach to the coracoid process? And to give you a clue, there are three muscles and four ligaments. So the answers. The answer to question one was the celiac artery, which is also the celiac trunk, which is the first branch from the anterior aspect of the abdominal aorta. It arises at the vertebral level of T12. It almost immediately divides into its three terminal branches, which are the left gastric artery, the splenic artery, and the common hepatic artery. The celiac artery is the major artery that supplies the foregut, and these three branches go on to supply the stomach, the spleen, the liver, and esophagus, and also parts of the pancreas and duodenum. Question two was about the cerebral nerve, which is a purely sensory nerve that is formed by a combination of two nerves. One branch is from the tibial nerve, which arises in the popliteal fossa, and it passes out and over the two heads of gastrocnemius muscle. And the other branch is from the common peroneal nerve. Both of these nerves are, of course, constituents of the sciatic nerve. The cerebral nerve descends on the posterolateral aspect of the leg, and it travels behind the lateral malleolus of the distal fibula at the ankle joint. It actually passes deep to the fibularis or peroneal tendon sheath, where it terminates into the lateral calcaneal branches and the lateral dorsal cutaneous nerve. The cerebral nerve supplies the skin over the posterolateral aspect of the distal third of the leg and the lateral aspect of the foot, heel, and ankle. Question three, Guillain's canal, is found in the ulnar side of the wrist, and it is quite superficial. It is about 4 centimeters in length, and it has four borders. The floor is made of the flexor retinaculum, which is also known as the transverse carpal ligament. The roof consists of the volar carpal ligament, or the palmar carpal ligament, which is a thickened portion of the antebrachial fascia of the wrist. It often gets confused with the flexor retinaculum, but actually it lies more superficial and proximal to the flexor retinaculum. The radial border is the hook of the hamate bone, which is a carpal bone. The medial border is made of the pisiform bone along with the pisohamate ligament. Now, Guillain's canal contains the ulnar nerve, which divides in this region into its superficial sensory branch and deep motor branches. The ulnar nerve can get compressed in the canal, and this causes altered sensation to the little and half of the ring finger, and also causes weakness in the hand, as the ulnar nerve supplies most of the small muscles in the hand, except for the thenar muscles, which act on the thumb, and the lateral two lumbricals. Guillain's canal is named after Jion Guillain, a French surgeon who first described it in 1861. Question four was about the tonsils. Now, the tonsils are a group of lymphatic tissues located in the pharynx. Together, they form a ringed arrangement known as Waldeyer's ring. There are four groups of tonsillar tissue: the pharyngeal tonsil, the tubal tonsils, the palatine tonsils, and the lingual tonsil. The pharyngeal tonsil lies within the mucosa of the roof of the nasopharynx. These tonsils are commonly called the adenoids, and they form the superior aspect of Waldeyer's ring. The tubal tonsils are situated near the opening of the auditory or eustachian tube in the lateral wall of the nasopharynx, so they form the lateral aspect of Waldeyer's ring. The palatine tonsils are what we commonly refer to as the tonsils, and they're situated in the lateral oropharynx wall between the palatoglossal arch anteriorly and the palatopharyngeal arch posteriorly. And they also form the lateral part of Waldeyer's ring along with the tubal tonsils. The lingual tonsils are lymphoid nodules which are found in the submucosa of the posterior third of the tongue, which gives the tongue its irregular or roughened appearance towards the back of the tongue surface. The lingual tonsils form the inferior part of Waldeyer's ring. So who was this Waldeyer? Well, Heinrich Waldeyer Hartz was a German anatomist who died in Berlin in 1921. Question 5 was about the coracoid process. The coracoid process is one of three bony projections that extends from the lateral part of the scapula or shoulder blade, the others being the glenoid and the acromion. The three muscles that attach to the coracoid include the coracobrachialis, the short header biceps, and the pectoralis minor, which attaches to the medial aspect of the coracoid. The four ligaments that attach to the coracoid are the coracohumeral ligament, which provides stability to the glenohumeral joint, the coracoacromial ligament, which spans from the coracoid process to the acromion of the scapula itself. So it's slightly unusual as it goes from one bit of one bone to another bit of the same bone. And finally, the two coracoclavicular ligaments also attach the coracoid. These are the trapezoid and conoid ligaments that stabilize the acromioclavicular joint. So how did you do this week? If you liked our quiz, give us a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, tell all your friends, and remember, it's Friday! So stay funky! Your anatomy matters.